You're getting better. You're starting to pick fights again. This time with another unlikely female, as Howard 100 News investigates.
Howard 100 News investigates.
I had some pregnant girl in here, I did.
What happened?
What happened is she wanted to share her cigarettes with me after I shared my cigarettes, and then she was eating pickles, and I asked for a pickle with water, and she ignored me, and if you don't believe me, this girl will even tell you. No.
In a rather odd turn of events, Bigfoot beginning to explain an argument he got into with a, quote, pregnant girl when he put a different woman on the phone to explain.
The woman was just a complete bitch. She wanted to stay and help him out, acted like she was doing it to be nice and shit, and didn't do anything for him, completely ignored him, made his whole house filthy. As soon as she started coming around here, she made it out, she had no place to live. And all this other shit, you're just rude.
It's still not clear why that woman got on the phone, or why the woman Bigfoot got into an argument with was in his home in the first place. Why was she in your house?
Pretty good.
Let me tell you who's sitting here. I'm here. Robin's here.
Good morning.
Robin's my co-hostess. I just want to introduce you to everyone. And the great Pat Cooper. You know Pat.
Yeah, fine.
Bob, how are you?
I'm fine.
Now, let me tell you something, Bob. First of all, I don't know if you know this. I should probably call you Mr. Hope, right?
Right.
Should I call you Mr. Hope?
You feel that you should.
I think I should.
I don't think you should. I think you should say, hey there.
Well, I'm like a young punk compared to you, and I've done nothing in the business. I'm barely in the business. I mean, if you want to... I mean, the fact that you would acknowledge that I'm in the business is...
We're not in the same business, he is.
Yeah, we're really not. Would you consider us in the same business as you?
Absolutely.
You would?
Why not?
That's very generous of you.
Let me applaud that. Thank you.
You're a generous and gracious man.
No, seriously, Bob, because... I mean, Mr. Hope. I look at my own career... And I say, look, I've been around now 15 years. I've yet to be in a film. I've yet to, I have a TV show, but it's an embarrassment. I have a radio program, but to me, radio is really, and nowadays, considered the lowest rung of show business, next to carnival work.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Not true.
Hey, Dan.
I think there is something, stripping, I think, is lower than radio.
Yeah, strip clubs. I mean...
House to house.
Right. Stripping house to house, even though strippergrams is lower than what I do. Alright? So to me, I see a stripper, I go, you're not in show business. But you understand what I'm saying. To talk to someone, like Pat Cooper was just saying, what were you saying about Bob? I mean, just so.
I said, this gentleman is a true superstar. When I hear youngsters out there who go to comedy clubs and call themselves a star, they haven't worked a garage yet.
Right.
There's a man that's done it all. And still doing it all, that's a true, true superstar. And I don't say it to frighten the gentleman, he knows what I mean, he is just beautiful.
Now, Mr. Holt, explain to me how you managed to leap from vaudeville to, like, NBC, and you skipped Channel 9 and all that stuff.
I just want to know how long it took you.
No, I did. I left from vaudeville to radio.
Yeah, but that's when radio was good.
Was when radio was television.
You know, now you got all these dirty comics.
I think before television, isn't it?
Yes.
Yeah, let me tell you something.
Anything. There was nothing, and you were around. Yeah.
Hey, Mr. Hope, can I do my impression for you of you?
Yeah.
Have you ever heard it? I can do you.
All right.
Tell me what you think. Are you ready? This is my Bob Hope. All right, ready?
Yeah.
Okay, here I go. I'm a little nervous, okay? Here I go.
Hey, how you doing, ladies and gentlemen? My, it's great to be here. How about a big round of applause for Angelina? Hey, how about that Rick Dees, boy? I tell you, I've been on TV 50 years and he didn't make it 50 days. Hey, how about that? Come on, give it up.
What do you think?
Hey, you got the tone. Hey, how about that?
Yeah, how do you like that? Come on, that's pretty good, isn't it?
That's the best.
I love radio, though, boy, when you can just, you know, get a big laugh, kiss the script.
Yeah.
And when you walk out, just drop the script in a can and just go right to the golf course. The hell with the makeup or anything else.
Let me tell you something. And I never told this to Robin. I never told this to anybody. I never told it to Pat Cooper. I didn't tell anybody. I want to tell it. I've been saving it for the hope that I could, you know, speak to you. After I saw the movie, I'll Take Sweden. That's when I decided to be in show business.
That's true. That is a true story.
That is a true story.
I don't know how he got here.
That's it. That was the movie that did it for me.
I'll Take Sweden.
Yep. What do you think of that?
That was all right. That was a little later.
Yeah, but I liked it. Hey, let me tell you something. You know what? I got to...
You know what my favorite Bob Hope movie is? I've never told you this.
What is your favorite Bob Hope movie?
The Lemon Drop Kid.
Yeah.
Yeah, that was one of them.
Really?
Yeah.
You know, they just released that for the public to do.
It really?
Yeah. Well,
I'll have to pick that up. I haven't seen it in a long time.
They released six of them. One of them is Lemon Drop Kid.
Do you own those movies? Do you own any piece of those movies still?
I owned about 12 of them.
Wow.
I made 59, but I own 12 of them. That's bad management.
Oh, man.
So I was happy to get the work, believe me.
So let me get this straight. See, nobody, every time I see you on TV shows now, people just have you on the TV show, and they just do tributes to you and stuff. Nobody asks you the real questions. I want to know what your day is like now.
How do I?
I mean, what's your day like now? I mean, here you are. Pat Cooper just said you're worth $500 million. I mean, seriously, you're a super rich guy.
I'm just sort of retired.
You're not semi-retired. But here you got, like, all this money. See, what I would do is I would just hang out all day, like, on a boat, and just hang out and enjoy.
That's the dullest. You find me on the golf course.
Yeah, on the golf course. But you go on the golf course. Like,
play golf every day.
you wake up?
I'm a late nighter.
All right, so what do? You wake up what?
I get up around 10 o'clock.
All right, 10 o'clock in the morning. That sounds wonderful. Right there, I like it.
10 o'clock, I read the paper, have my breakfast.
Okay. What do you have for breakfast?
It all depends what I'm doing, you know.
Right.
I got a lot of things I do.
Yeah, but what do you have? Like, you have like a what? Like cereal or something for breakfast? What
do you
have?
We want to know everything.
I want to know everything about your life. You have a cereal for breakfast or what do you eat, toast?
No, I got a fruit man.
You eat a lot of fruit. Because listen, I mean, you know,
the best in the world. I open with fruit and have a juice and that's it for a while.
No coffee.
No, not right away.
All right. Then all of a sudden you get dressed and you go.
Now wait a minute. Does he have a lot of servants?
You got a lot of servants in your house?
Enough.
Really?
So when army.
How many in help you got?
Now we have. I have one upstairs maid that my wife doesn't know about.
Real?
Yeah. You're my kind of guy, Bob.
Yeah.
Jack Pearl.
I like that.
See, because I'm wondering if he even dresses himself.
Do you have to dress yourself, or do you have like special people who come in and just like even just put your clothes on? See, if I had that much money, there'd be people dressing me all day. Dressing and undressing me all day.
No, I don't like that. Take that off.
Mr. Hope, seriously, what do you do? Like, do you pick out your own clothes?
I think so, yeah.
Really?
Sure, dude.
What? And look, what do you got? You got like a regular maid who like makes breakfast and stuff. Then you got like someone who cleans the house. So what do you have? Like five people around you?
I don't know. Let me see. I'll get about that.
Wow.
That's right.
Well, we have a lot of, you know, we got a big house, a lot of people.
Man. Boy, if I had all that money, I'd be sitting around deciding which state to buy. That's what I do. I say, yeah, I'll buy Nevada. I like it. Let me tell you something. See, now this is what I admire most. Most of the people I meet in show business are idiots when it comes to business.
Mm-hmm.
All right? They're in the show, but they're not in the business.
Right? Like us.
Yeah, like us. Like we get a couple of dollars, and we don't even know what to do with it. You see what I'm saying? How did you know back then to buy the real estate? How did you know what to buy?
I did my brother a favor.
Yeah.
My brother was taking care of some property. He had nothing to do with it. He wanted the real estate. And he used to come down and tell me about the real estate. Hey, this is a 30-acre piece over there. What is it? So I was making pictures and radio and doing all this stuff.
And you had some money.
I said, yeah, I had some money. I said, buy it.
Right.
I never even dreamed, but I missed some of the big stuff.
Right. Well, let me tell you this.
So what we need is a brother who's doing nothing.
I wish your brother was here with me. I'm like bankrupt.
I wish he was with you, too.
Now, let me explain why Bob is calling. Bob isn't just calling in because he likes me.
Well, Bob is a businessman, so there must be something behind it.
Yeah, now let me explain something to you. Bob, let me sell this, please. I mean, Mr. Hope, pardon me.
Like Johnny, we would like to read your plug.
Right, let me read your plug here. You gotta understand.
Even Johnny calls him Mr. Hope. What do you call him? Did you call him Bob?
No, I did by accident.
You can call me anything you want.
No.
Johnny calls you Mr.
It's Mr. Hope. Listen, please. I'm a flea on your...
Because we call Johnny Mr. Carson.
I'm a flea in show business. You understand that. Have you ever even heard of me before?
Sounds like you're warming me up for a small amount.
I'm hoping you'll remember me. You know what I'm saying? Like maybe the next big special you let me be in it. You know what I mean? Me and Brooke Shields.
You and he could do a duet.
Yeah. How about that, Brooke Shields, boy? Right? Angie something?
See, I see you on the Christmas special. And Bob on a horse-drawn carriage.
With our smoking jackets.
Singing a carol.
How about that? Thanks for the memory. Bob Hope.
Do me a favor. Blow your nose, will you?
Yeah. Bob Hope. Now, let me explain something to you. Now, this is very serious. This is not a laughing matter. Pat Cooper will back me up on this. To see a comic of Bob Hope's stature, where you can actually be close to Bob Hope, this is a rare opportunity. Now, you know.
I think the last time he was here and performed live, weren't you at Madison Square Garden?
Yeah, with George
Burns.
Right, so see, this is a difference. This is intimate.
Yeah, I like this better because, quite frankly, I don't want to say I saw Bob Hope at Madison Square Garden because that means I was like probably 100 rows back. But this way, Bob can see you, and you can see Bob.
Yeah. One of the best theaters in the country.
Yeah, it's a beautiful spot. I've been there about 10 times, and I'll tell you, it's so intimate. You're so right.
Now, is this a chance for you?
You can really entertain there.
And you can get wild there.
because you're close to the people.
Absolutely.
It's not like you got the network cameras on you. You can get, well, I'm not going to say racy, but you can get a little bit blue, can't you? Yes, I know what you're saying. I know what you're saying. I'm reading between the lines. I understand what you're saying. And I understand you will be there with Angelian.
Angelian,
right. I tell you, boy, that Angelian, she's something.
You tell me, baby.
Boy, she can do it all, can't she? Huh? Can she do it?